קהל קדוש, בוקר טוב, מסכת פסחים, קי"ג עמוד א', 113, גמרא. אמר לרב לרבסי, says רב to רבסי, לא תדור במטה דלא צניף בסוסיה. A person should not live in a city where you cannot hear the horses, or ולא נבח בקלבה, or in a city where you do not have the dogs that they're barking for שמירה. Why? Because of the גנבים and the אויבים. Which means if people are not going to hear that there's any dogs or there's any other horses or things like that, so robbers, bandits, thieves, they're going to come and they're going to think, listen, the city is open, free, they could do whatever they want, and then they're going to come. So a person should never live in such a city that there's no dogs barking or no horses, which are, you know, you could hear the noise of the horses. Ve'al tadur be'ir deresh mata asya, right? Don't live in a city where the head of the city is a doctor. Why? Because since, just like we learned about Tamidei Chachamim, since he's going to be so busy, he's a doctor, so he can't pay attention to anything that the city actually needs. Okay? Velo tinsuv tarte, a person should not, right, get married to two women. Why? Because what's going to happen is maybe they're going to come together to do him negative. Ina siv tarte, right, but if he still gets married to two women, so then nasiv tlat, so then get married to a third one. Right? Why? Because even if you're going to have two that are going to go against him, the third one will come and she'll reveal it to him. So therefore, right, I guess it's also the zugot problem. No, don't get married just to the couple, to the pair, to three. Okay? Alush, you heard the advice. That's the way to do it. It's either one or three. Yeah, it's either one or three.
Why?
Okay, fine. Says the Gemara. Amar le'rav, rav le'rav kahana, says rav to rav kahana, hafoch benevilta velo tepuch bemile. What does that mean? Hafoch benevila, if you need to, but don't change the words, right? Which means, if you need to, change in a nevila. Nevila is a dead carcass, if you really need to, but don't change your words. Because always be makpid on the emet, on the truth, and be careful to fulfill everything that your mouth and your words say. Peshot nevilta beshuka ushkil agra. Take off the or, the skin of a nevela in the shuk, and take the reward for your work. Even though that means if a person really needs parnasa, he's even going to work in the taking off the skins and everything of the animals, which is a terrible job. Don't think it's, you know, it smells. It's not the velo teima kana ana vegavre rabba ana vesanya bimilta. And a person shouldn't say, no, I'm a kohen, I'm an adam gadol. I'm, you know, everything's hated on me, done that, you know, I'm not going to do that. How could I do such a thing? If a person needs parnasa, he's going to need to do things. That whatever it is, that's the way it is. Okay? Salakt le'igra shirutech ba'adach. Right? When a person comes and he goes up from the house to the roof, right? It says over here, you should have your food with you. Right? Which means even if you're going to go for a very short way, you should always have some food. Right? You should always have something in your hands. Me'a kare be'mata bezuza. Even if the price of food is very, very cheap, right, that they're selling 100 pumpkins with one zuz, tute kenafach neve, you should always have mizonot underneath, which means you should always have some, right? It says over here, you know, you should always have some things, you know, so it's very, very important that a person should always have the mizonot and things like that, right? That means never rely upon, even if you can find food, always have some food, right? No matter what. You never know what happens. You know, you don't know how many times people go and they say, no, there's kosher food in the airport. They go there, it's all run out. It's not this, it's not that, it's not fresh. You know, there's always something. So a person should always have, yeah? So then it says, Amar le'rav le'chia bere. So says Rav to Chia his son, La tishte sama. A person should not drink any type of a sam, potion, right? Maybe they're going to sell it and you're going to lose money from it. And even in fua, don't drink it, right? If you have another way of doing it. Meaning don't just take potions if you could get healed in another way. Velati shva nigra, right? Don't jump from the amata maim, right? That means don't jump over like an irrigation canal, like over a little stream as a kitzur derech. Why? Because maybe, it says, okay, it could be that he'll fall inside and put himself in sakana. But there's different reasons brought down there in the Rashbam why he shouldn't jump over this like canal that has water. It says here, do not, if a person has, right, a pain in their teeth, do not uproot the teeth, because afterwards it could be that it'll heal the pain in the teeth. And he doesn't realize that at the end of the day, you know, it could heal and he's pulling out his teeth, which is very valuable. Right? Do not start up with a snake. Yeah, why? Because you're going to start up with a snake, the snake will come and bite. Don't start up with an Aramai, with an Aramean, which is a goy. There are three things that you don't start up with them. Nochri, a goy, katan, v'nachash katan, v'talmid katan. It says whether it's going to be a nochri katan, which is basically a small child, but a goy, or a nachash katan, a small serpent, or a talmid katan. My tama, what's the reasoning? The malchutai hu achorei b'nai hu kai. Because malchutam are behind their ears, which means that at the end of the day, they're going to become big. And when they come big, they want to take revenge. That's going to be bad. I mean, right now, maybe they can't do anything, but they'll remember what you did. And if they remember what a person did against them, it's not going to be good. Yeah, that's what he's saying. Amar le Rav le Aivu bere, says Rav to Aivu, his son, tar chebach bishmata, yeah, vela mistaya milta. Yeah, I was tarachti lelamandcha at shmuot atamul atzecha, which means that I was trying to come and trying to teach different things without atzlacha. Tag mercha mil dialma. So now I'm going to teach you, right, things of mischar, of different works and things like that. Okay? So that's what he's trying to teach him, different types of works and different types of jobs. So that's what he's trying to say, which means that even if I came and I tried to teach you Torah and I didn't have atzlacha, so for sure you have to go out to work, right? I'm still going to teach you derke olam, which are derke musar, mischar. Adichala karech, right? When you're going to come and you're going to start, when you still have the sand on your feet, when you're coming back, zevinach zabin, sell what you have, right? Without being mitakev whatsoever, without stopping, right? Kol mile zabin v'ticharet, because anything that you're going to sell and then afterwards you're going to regret because you sold it too quickly, bar mechamna de zabin v'lo ticharet, except for wine, that you should sell immediately and you'll never be mitcharet. Why? Because by wine is basically one of the only things that you're always afraid that maybe what's going to happen is that it's going to become worse. It's going to become vinegar. So because of that, that's the only thing that everything else, it could be you're going to regret selling it too quickly because you could have waited and that's it, right? Share kisach petach sakach. At the beginning, open up your anak, which is like your wallet, and put inside of it money that you got in. And only afterwards, open up your sack to take out the schura. Meaning, first you put the money into your wallet, and then afterwards you come and you take out what you have. Kaba me'ara velo kora mi'igra. It's better to get a meloa kav ba'aretz mashal yisakeh meloa kur me'agag, which means it's better to get a smaller amount of money and you live right beside your house, you're right beside yourself, than to get much more money and you're going to be in a very far away place. Okay? Tamra b'chaluzach, right, lebet sudana rahit. When you have tamarind dates in a utensil which is holding it, go to your house quickly to make the beer, right? Because if you're going to wait until you have a lot, it could be that they're going to eat it and you're going to lose it. Meaning it's much better even to make a smaller amount, but for sure you're going to have it than to come and to lose everything. So therefore, you have a small amount, make it right now. Don't start coming and doing other things. So how much? Until three se'im of tamarind. Okay? Fine. Now it says like this. Amar of Papa. The Papa says, "Ila dirmai shichra lo yatre." If I was going to be matil shechar, I wouldn't become rich. Ika de'amri. Some people say, Amar of Chasta says of Chasta, "Ila dirmai shichra lo yatre." If I wouldn't have put the shechar to become immediately beer, I wouldn't have become rich, right? My sudna. What exactly is the mekor of sudna, right? What does that mean, sudna, to become, right? He comes and he says, like this. Amar of Chasta, sod na'e. Gemilut chasadim. If you want a secret to become rich, right, you do gemilut chasadim, right? Why? Because when you come and you're going to do shechar, which is beer, it doesn't cost you a lot to make beer. So therefore, you could give a lot to the aniim without worrying that now you're going to lose so much of the principle. Which means a person wants a sunnah is sod na'e, that's sudna, is gimlut chasadim. So if a person is going to come, they're going to make beer. They come and they do a lot of chesed with the beer and nothing happens. The truth is I saw that a lot with people that they have, whether it's going to be stores or they have all these different things, right? They have this. Why? For example, they have a store and they make a lot of food. So they come all the time and they're giving food to the poor people as well. They're never going to really lose from the keren. They're really never going to lose from the principle. Because at the end of the day, how much does it cost to make an extra pound? anyway they're making it. And a lot of times they have leftovers. So the opposite, they come, right? And they do that. And they start giving out to the aniim, right? And it's a big chesed. Fine. Amar Rav Papa. Rav Papa says, kol agav, anything that you have to write in a document, for example, whether it's a loan or a sale on credit, even if it's going to start being written down, right? And you could come and collect it, gav yabai, you still always have to collect it. Which means not because you wrote it down in a document about a credit or about a loan, that that's it. You still need to collect the money. Kol ashrai, anything which is going to be balpe, which means a credit, on balpe, which is by heart. Nowadays also, how do they call the credit card? Kartis ashrai, right? Which means that it's on credit. Safek ate, safek lo ate. There's a safek, bichlal, whether you're going to pay it or not. Ude ate ma'ot ra'ot ninhu. And even if they are going to come, maybe it's not going to be the best money. Because remember, in the olden days, you could pay back with many different types of currencies, even bills and everything. Nowadays, everything paid through the bank, it's all the same. But once upon a time, I would come, I would pay you. But maybe I'm going to pay you with a currency which is not the best, or with money which is already wasting out, and not everyone will accept it. So therefore, he comes and he says, first of all, it's a fact whether they're going to pay or not, and also, you know, whether bichlal it's going to be good currency. There are three things that Rabbi Yochanan said in the name of Anshei Yerushalayim. Number one, when you go to war, don't go first, go last. In order that you should be the first one to come back into the city. Okay, that's going to be number one. He says that it doesn't make sense. He says, why? If you're going to be the last one to go out, so you're the last one to be put into sakana. So what exactly is this going, you know, why is it, you know, the opposite way, as it to say? Apparently there's a Ben Yehuda here. I'll let Binyamin, I'm going to give you some homework. Find out from the Ben Yehuda, what does the Ben Yishchai say? What's, you know, because I understand, you're going to be the last one to go out to the war, so you're in the back of the infantrymen. So usually you're the most protected, because the first ones which are going to be, you know, hit are the front lines. Everyone knows the front lines is the worst, right? But if you're going to be in the back, you're protected. But here it doesn't say that. It says you should be in the back lines, not because you're going to be protected, but rather when you come back home, you're the first ones that come back home. So I don't know. Interesting. Number two, make your Shabbat into a weekday, but don't require people, which means try to do everything what's possible in order to get away from tzedakah. Person should do everything. Even if he has to make a Shabbat like a weekday, which means that he's not going to have three seudot, or he's only going to have two seudot, or he's going to have the seudot like very, very minimal and things like that, but he always has to try not to get into getting tzedakah. Okay? Number three, this we already learned already. Try doing business with somebody that he has a sha'a mesachekelo. Sha'a mesachekelo means he's got the mazal playing for him. He's got a good mazal. So when he's got a good mazal, make sure that he's, you know, that you start doing business with him, a partnership with him, because that way it'll be good for you as well. Okay, next. There were three things that Mishob Levi said in the name of Anshei Yerushalayim. Also three general advices. So imagine, look at the good advices that we had throughout, whether it's yesterday's daf, the day before yesterday, today's daf, they're all good advices. Yeah? Number one. Yeah, he says over here, Al tarbe bignut mishum ma'aseh shaya. Yeah, don't do things in a negative way, which means in a negative way in front of other people, because of the story with David and Bathsheba. Here it says in the footnote, Bathsheba was the wife of Uriah Hiti, right? Obviously, she was there, the famous story on the roof, right? And David saw her. So because of that, the entire story started because of how he saw her there on the roof. Okay? So it says over here, so he says, Alta bebe gagot. Fine, because people could actually see you. Yeah? So he comes and he says, right? Al tarbe bignut mishum ma'aseh shaya. Okay, number two. Bitcha bagra shachrer avdecha veten la. The second that your daughter is already old enough, what should you do? Shachrer avdecha, right? Which means, right? How do you call it? Shachrer avdecha. Liberate your servant and give it to her, which means that the second that she's already of an age, so then you're going to free your servant in order to give her as a wife. Here it says, Rabbi Yoshua Ben Levi was teaching us, which means it's very, very important to get your daughter married the second that she becomes a bogeret. Remember, bogeret is 12 and a half. So he says, so it's even better to free your slave, that she should get married to your slave, than to stay an old maid, They called her an old maid, no? A woman that's not married. So obviously nowadays that age changed because nobody's getting married at 12 and a half. But it was in the olden days, that was a concept, which means that they didn't want that it should be in such a fashion, right? That, you know, that the, you know, that means if she's already going to be at an age that nobody took her yet, make sure that you're going to come, right? And you're going to give her to the husband. Number three, be very careful of your wife because of the first chatan, right? My tama, what's the reasoning? Rav Chasda amar, Rav Chasda says, mishum erva, right? Because, right, it's going to become a erva. Rav Kahana amar, mishum mamon. Rav Kahana says, because maybe you're going to come and you're going to spend too much money. Veha veha, it's new. But it says the Gemara, you have to be careful because of both reasons. Which means that the first chatan, the first son-in-law, the wife, she wants that he should be very good to the daughter, right? So therefore, she's going to be very nice to him. But because of that, there could be problems. So because of that, they say, be very careful, mishum erva. Second reason, it could be that, again, the same thing, that the mother wants that her daughter should have such good things that she's going to come and she's going to really start spending and spending and spending a whole bunch of money on him. And because of that, he says, because of both reasons, a person should be careful, right, because of the first son-in-law. Okay? Fine. Amar Rabbi Yochanan, says Rabbi Yochanan, Shlosha minochale olam haba. There are three people that they get, olam haba. Veluen, these are the three people. Dar Beretz Yisrael, somebody that's going to live in Eretz Yisrael. Number two, am gadel banav, Talmud Torah, somebody that's going to bring up his children to Talmud Torah. Number three, somebody that's going to do Avdalah and wine and Motzei Shabbat. By the way, you should know, this is the reason why Rav Chaim Kanievsky used to always tell people, it's also segula for banim, for children, but he always used to tell people, make sure you do Avdalah, not on grape juice, on wine. So therefore, there's an extra inyan. Some people will do it on beer, on that. No. Wine, that's written here. This Gimala. A person should be very cautious and always Avdalah on wine. Yeah, that's what's brought down over here. Okay, Maihi. What does that mean? Avdalah layayin. The Mishayer mikudush al avdalta. That he says that if he only has a little bit of wine, so he should not drink the entire thing on Shabbat in order that he should leave some over for Avdalah. Which means, again, person should have wine for Avdalah. Okay? Amar Rabbi Yochanan, says Rabbi Yochanan, Shlosha machliz alem HaKadosh Baruch Hu. There are three people that Kadosh Baruch Hu mentions on them their chassidut every single day. When you have a ravak, a person that's a single, a bachelor, that he's living in a city and he doesn't sin. The fact that he's not sinning, HaKadosh Baruch Hu mentions how much of a chassid he is. Okay? Number two, he says, why dafka bikrach? Because obviously there's a lot of women around. Number two, a poor person, he found something and he still returns it to the owners. Which means that he's poor, so he could rightfully, you know, there's a big yitzhara, he wants to keep it. But no, he's going to come and he's going to return it to the owners. Chassidut. Number three, v'alashir hame'aser perota betzina. Right, which means on an ashir, on a rich person, that he's taking off ma'aser privately. Why? If he's doing it publicly, it shows that he's doing it for his own kavod. Look how much ma'aser he's giving and all these things. He's doing it privately, which people are not going to see, even though he's giving ton, he's giving you a huge, right? A very, very large amount. So that's also, that's a chassidut. Okay, Rav Safra, Ravak Adar Bikrachava. Rav Safra was actually, he was a Ravak, right? He was a bachelor that he used to live in a city. Okay? Huf Yudgim Amudbet, 113b. Tani Tana Kamed the Rava of Rav Safra. So there was a chacham that top right out in front of Rava Rav Safra. Tzavu Panav the Rav Safra. The second that Rav Safra heard this, his face became lit. Amalo Rava, Rava says, Love Kigon more. We're not talking about somebody like you, right? Why? It's like Rav Chanin Roshia, Davu Ushpache Barad Yisrael, because they were sandlers in Eretz Yisrael. And they were sitting in the shuk of the Zonot, and they were coming and they were making shoes for them. Inu Mistakle Behu, they were looking at them. But them. Rav Hoshaya and Rav Chanina never picked up their eyes to look at these women. So because of that, right, umimotayu hachi, and they would swear, bechayehen rabbanan kadishe devarad Yisrael. That means these women, they actually realized they were the low lives, but they actually realized that they used to swear on the lives of these holy rabbis of Eretz Yisrael, which means that the second that they realized how holy they were, that they wouldn't look at them even, right? And they were right there. That's what showed them that it was the holiness. Shlosha HaKadosh Baruch Hu Ovan. Three people HaKadosh Baruch Hu, he loves them. Mishen o Koes, somebody that does not get angry. Yeah, so somebody that does not get angry, HaKadosh Baruch Hu loves him. Misheno mishtaker, somebody that doesn't get drunk. Yeah, so he says, what's the third one? Umisheno ma'amid amidotav. And somebody that's not going to be ma'amid amidotav, which means he's not strict on his midot, meaning even somebody is going to do something against him, selkear, he's going to give up. You know, he's going to forgo very easily. He's going to forgive. Shloshah HaKadosh Baruch Hu sonean, the three people that HaKadosh Baruch Hu hates. Who are those three people? Amdaber echa bepe v'echa balev, somebody that speaks, one in his heart and one in his mouth. Somebody that knows testimony about his friend and he doesn't testify. Number three, somebody that sees something of an erva with his friend and he's going to testify against him. He had the tuvia achata, just like tuvia, right? That he did an avera in arayot, but tuvia sinned. And came zigud by himself and he started testifying in front of the papa. Nagdel zigud, Rav Papa came. And he gave lashes to Zigud, not to Tuvia, to Zigud. Amalei, so says, he told Rav Papa, Tuvia chata vezigud min gad? He says, don't understand. Tuvia sinned, and you're giving me the lashes? Amalei, he said, in yes, why? Tichtiv, as it says in the pasuk, lo yakum ed echad ba'ish. One witness should not testify about his friend. At lechuda chasadabe, you're testifying by yourself. Shemra be'alma makama, you're just giving a shemra. Meaning anyway, you're by yourself, so you can't do anything. So if you can't do anything, because you always need two witnesses, what are you coming and stunned telling me? You don't have to put out a bad name on him? Meaning that if anyway, you can't testify against him and you can't do anything. So what are you doing? Stunned putting a bad name. So therefore you get lashes. Shemra, you get lashes. Okay? Amar Rabbi Shmuel bar Yitzchak Amar Rav, says Rabbi Shmuel bar Yitzchak, the name of Rav, mutar lesanoto. Not only that, if he comes and he testifies by himself against another person, you're allowed to hate him. If you're going to come and see the chamol of your enemy that he's underneath the burden, azov ta azov imo, you have to help him. My sone, what does it mean he hates him? If you're going to tell me sone nochri a goy, we already learned sone shamru, sone yisrael, it has to be a Jew, not a goy. El apshita brother, sone yisrael, it has to be a Jew. Umay shali al misa, so why are you permitted to hate him? You're not allowed to hate your brother in your heart. But rather, there's witnesses that he did an isud. Okay. So everyone's going to hate him because of his avera. What's the difference? But rather, it's the case is, he saw a dvarivah by him. So therefore, since he saw it, so that's why he's allowed to hate him. How could that be? Right? But rather, for sure, the pasuk is talking about that since he went and he saw him, right? That means the person that sees him doing the avera, so he's allowed to hate him, right? But he's not allowed to testify about him. He's allowed to hate him because of the ma'aseh avera, but he's not allowed to testify against him. Because testifying against him, Sami saying mitzvah shumra. But he's allowed to do this. Rav Nachman bar Yitzchak Amar, Rav Nachman bar Yitzchak says, mitzvah lesanoto, it's a mitzvah to hate him. Shneimar, yirat Hashem sinaot ra. The yirat Hashem, the fear of God, is somebody that hates the evil. Amar Ravacha bere derava lervashi, says Ravacha, the son of Ravava to Ravashi, are you permitted, right, to tell it to his rabbi in order that he should also hate him? So at least you should tell his rabbi. Amalei, he says, if the rabbi is going to believe him like two people, then he should tell him. But if he's not going to believe him, meaning if he's going to tell the rabbi and the rabbi will believe him and therefore he's going to try to get him to stop and so on and so forth, then yes. But if he's not going to believe him, right, and he's so then better not say anything. Tanu Rabbanam, we learned in a braita. Another important one. Shlosha chayehem enam chayim. There are three people that their lives are not considered lives. Right? Their lives are not considered life. Harachmanin, people that are too merciful. Latchanin, people that they get angry too much. I mean, it's too merciful is not too good. Also too angry. Vanine adat, people that are finicky. They're very meticulous, very peculiar, very, right? V'amar Rav Yosef said everything is in with him. He's too merciful. He gets angry too much. Right? And he's an istinis. Very interesting, because I would have said, right here it says that Rav Yosef was blind. So that's why he felt that everything was with him. Very interesting. I would have said that they were two opposites, because somebody that's a ratchan, Baruch Hashem, he says it here in the footnote. Hadavar maflish Rav Yosef sheya anav atzum, he was very humble. How could he get angry? And even more, that usually anger and rachmanut and passion, compassion and mercy are opposites. Right? So he comes and he says, that means his nature was to get angry very much. So in order to come and to go to the other side, he became a Rahman and a Nanav to the other side, in order that it should actually, you know, come and awaken him, and that way he won't get angry. But by nature, he was a person that got angry very, very much, but he had to work upon himself in order to get that off. Okay, Tanu Rabbanan, we learned in a Braita. Shlosha sonim zeh zeh. There are three groups that they hate each other. Velu en klavim, tanegolim, v'achabarim. So the dogs hate each other, tanegolim, by the roosters, and chabarim. What is chabarim? It says here, mibnei parsim lumat zeh. Okay, they're different. Some people say it's like the komre, like the priests of the parsim. Right? Some people say afazonot, even the zonot. Right? Because it means even though they're doing it in front of each other, they're coming and they're doing things in front of everybody, but at the end of the day, right, they hate each other as well. Some people say even the Talmidei Chachamim of Bavel. Right? So that's the Maharal. There's a whole question here about exactly what does that mean. Okay? Tanu Rabbanan, we learned in a right. There are three people that they love each other. Number one, Ve'eluena Agerim, Avadim Vorvim. The Gerim. Right? So the Gerim, they love each other, the converts. Avadim, slaves, and Orvim, and the ravens. Okay? Arba'a en Datz of Latan. There are four people that people just can't stand them. Ve'eluena, these are the four people. Dal Ge'e, a person that's poor, but he's haughty. Meaning if a person is rich and he's haughty, that's one thing. But if he's poor and he's haughty, it's even worse. Ve'ashir mekachesh, a rich person that he's saying that he didn't have money of his friend, which means he's rich. You're going to say, Iowa, the guy's rich. He's still going to refuse, or you're going to reject that you didn't have money by him. The guy, you know, the guy has money. Zaken menaef, an elderly person that he's committing adultery. Why? Because he's a zaken. Right? What's he doing exactly? Okay, number four, parnas mitgael atzibur, a parnas, which he's going to be mitgael atzibur, which means that he's going to be haughty on the tzibur. This is talking about a parnas that he's mitgael atzibur, which means that he's like in charge of the tzibur, and he's being haughty, and he's going you know, in front of them with no reason. Some people say, we're talking about somebody that's going to divorce his wife the first time, right, then the second time, right, and then he brings him back. Or brings her back as well. Okay, Vetana Kama, and according to the Tana Kama, he comes and says, Zimna diktubata merubah. Sometimes it happens that the ketubah is just too much. Inami, and some people say, and that's why he's doing that, right? That means he's coming and he has to give her a ketubah, which is very, very big amount. Inami yeshlo bani memen av lo atzim yeshla, or he has children, so therefore he doesn't want to come and he doesn't want to divorce from her. So in some of those cases, right, so velet adat nagu kazu. So you know, they just have to keep quiet. You understand? That's why. Chamisha dvarim tziva Kenan et benav. There were five things that Kenan commanded his children. Right, this Gemara is also in Bab Batra. We spoke about it on Shavuot. So pay attention. Five things Kenan commanded his children. Okay. It says over here, ehevu zeze, love each other. Right. Let me just 1 second. So it says, ehevu ze etze. You have to love each other. Ehevu et gazel, love to steal. Ehevu et zima, love promiscuity, love immorality. Vesinu et adonechem, hate your masters. Ve'al tedabru emet, and don't speak the truth. Five things that Kenan taught his children, and until today, it's still true. Each one of these five things. Shisha dvarim ne'marim basus. There are going to be six things which are brought down to do with the horses. Ohevet aznut, ve'ohevet amilchama, v'ruchol gasa, mo'eset shina ve'ochel arbe motzi kima, v'yeshomim v'mekesh ha'arub alav milchama. It says here, they love immorality, the znut. Ohevet amilchama, they love war. Ruchol gasa, the horse is always with his nose up, right? He's always haughty. Mo'eset shina, he doesn't like to sleep, right? He hates sleep, okay? Ve'ochel arbe, he eats a lot, u'motzi kima. Yeah, what does it mean, motzi kima? It says here, motzi kima doesn't even explain. Okay. V'yesh omrim, some people say, af mevakesh, right, la'arog be'alav b'milchama. He wants to kill even his own masters in war. Next, shiva menudin la'shamayim. There are seven people that they are excommunicated in Shamayim. Velu, and these are them. Yehudi she'en lo isha, a man, a Jew that does not have a wife. V'sheyesh lo isha ve'lo benim, or, right, he's got a wife, but he doesn't have children. Obviously, here it's because of not the infertility was caused because of a reason, but rather because he purposely didn't want children. Or he has children and he doesn't raise them up to Talmud Torah. He doesn't have to put on his tefillin, not in his head and not in his arm. tzitzit in his clothing. Mezuzah pepitzcho, he doesn't have a mezuzah. V'amoneh min l'beragav, he doesn't put on shoes. Yeshomrim, some people say, Av Yishem Mesev HaChavura Shel Mitzvah, he doesn't come and he doesn't go to a Chavura Shel Mitzvah. By the way, this is the reason why when it says that a person doesn't do he doesn't go to a Chavura Shel Mitzvah to eat, that's the reason why there's a minhag not to invite by a Brit Milah, by the Seudah of the Brit Milah. The reason why you don't invite for a Seudah of the Brit Milah is because of this. Because basically you're being invited to a Chavura Shel Mitzvah, so if you're not going to go, you're considered Menudeh L'Shamayim. You consider that you get an excommunication from the heavens. So because of that, we just inform. We don't invite. Meaning nobody's going to come and say, you're invited to the Seudah of the Brit Milah. We're informing. Okay? Amar Rabba Baruchana. Yeah, Amar Rabbi Shimon Bar Mata, Amar Rabbi Mishumi Rabbi Yoseh, Ishu Tzal. So says Rabbi Baruchana, the name of Shimon Bar Mata, the name of Rabbi Yoseh, Ishu Tzal. Minayin Shen Sholim Bekaldeim. How do you know that we don't ask in these stargazers? You have to be tamim with Hashem, your God. How do we know that if your friend is greater than even one thing that you're obligated to give him kavod? Which means because of the ruach of the chokhmah, which was extra, that's why the king wanted to put him on the entire memlecha. Right? And somebody that's going to be sitting on Dam Tahor, remember Dam Tahor is after the 7 or the 14 of giving birth to a male or a female, you have Dam Tahor. So this is prohibited to have marital relations. Ad kama until when? Amarav says ona, one ona, which is going to be a day period or a night period, whichever one it is. Tana hu Yosef Yishutzal, hu Yosef Avli. So they taught in a Braita that Yosef Yishutzal was also the same name as Yosef Avli. Who is Ben Gur Aryeh, who is Ben Yehuda? Isi Ben Gur Aryeh is the same person as Isi Ben Yehuda, who is Ben Gamliel, who is Ben Malalel. Umashimo, what's his real name? Isi Ben Akavyashimo. So these are just coming and telling you who are these different people, that all of these names are the same person, but obviously there were different reasons why they had different names. Whether it was they had to change their names or for different reasons, whatever it is, but it was the same person. Huda Yitzhak Ben Tavla, Huda Yitzhak Ben Chakla. Same person, Yitzhak Ben Chavla, Ben Chakla, or Ben Tavla. Which is Rabbi Yitzhak ben Acha, Dishmatehu, right? So the Kufiyu Dalet Amud Aleph. We're just going to try to get to the Mishnah on 114a1, right? So it says Rabbi Yitzhak ben Acha, Dishmatehu, when he's mentioned, Rabbi Yitzhak ben Pinchas Tagatahu, it's going to be, that means if it's a Braita, it's Rabbi Yitzhak ben Acha. If it's Rabbi Yitzhak ben Pinchas, then it's going to be of the Agata, the stories. The Simanach, what's the Siman? Shema'uni Achai, Achai Ve'ami. Which means when we're talking about the Shimua is Le'acha. So here it says in the footnote. So what does that mean? That the Rabbi Yitzhak ben Acha is the beginning. So it says Rabbi Yitzhak ben Acha is the Braita, and Rabbi Yitzhak ben Pinchas is the Agata. So if you say Shema'uni Achai Ve'ami. So that's Acha. Okay, Rabbi Yitzhak ben Acha is like a Shmaita. Shmaita is Shimauni. Shmaita, that's how you remember. It's not a Gatta. So Shimaita, which is the Braito, is Acha, Rabbi Yitzhak ben Acha. Amar Rabbi Baruchan Rabbi Yochanan, Mishmed Rabbi Yehuda Rabbi Lai. He says Rabbi Yochanan, the name of Yochanan, the name of Rabbi Yehuda Rabbi Lai. Echol batzal veshev batzel. Eat betzalim, onions. Eat onions or other vegetables, okay, and sit in the tzel, in the shade of your house. And don't eat other types of expensive foods like ducks and, you know, roosters. Right? Because then you're going to want to eat more than when you really do it. And then you're going to have to start, meaning if you're going to start eating too much of delicacies, you're going to want more and more, and it's just too expensive. Spend less on food and drink and try to add more on your house. Kiata ula, which is a very interesting concept. Here it says, al pi pshuto, the kavanah is kedai lagdil. It's better to have a bigger house, even if you have to have less food, than to come and having more food in a smaller house, right? I think it's the opposite of maybe what a lot of the Moroccan Jewries. I don't know how it is with the Syrians, but they just, you know, no matter what, they could live in a little hole, but the food, they have to eat like kings. Yeah, what do you say, Benjamin? Is it the same by the Syrians or not?
Not always.
Not always. Okay. I know by Moroccans, Baba Khaki, what do you say by the Moroccans? They always had to eat like kings. They had to, mama, they eat with their eyes. So it doesn't matter where they eat, you know, like where they live, They have to eat well. No? Baba Chaki, what do you say?
It depends. It depends.
Yeah, okay. Let's see. So he says... Depends where.
Morocco, okay. In Morocco, it was, but here less, I think.
No. You're right. In Morocco, for sure. But here it's true. Here, I think it's less. But in Morocco, they had to... I remember doing, you know, whether it's PESA programs, well, they eat with their eyes. They have enough food. It doesn't matter. They have to see the abundance. They have to see the
benefits. Yeah, like Shabbat, three kind of fish on the table on Shabbat. Yeah, three kinds.
That's what I'm saying. So
here, one kind, it's enough.
Exactly. But there, they can live in a hole. But it doesn't matter. As long as they have the beracha, that's it. You know, they have to eat. So
you
here
have to understand, in Morocco, it was more easy. We used to have maids.
Right.
So, you know, the more difficult.
Yes. Kiata Ula Ununa came from Babel to Eretz Israel. Amar, he said, Matla Matzlim B'Ma'arava. They used to give a mashal in Eretz Israel. Right. The Achil Aliyata, if somebody's going to eat a fatty meat, Tashe Baliyata, he's going to hide himself in the roof, right? Which means he's going to start buying a whole bunch of things with credit. And then they're going to start, you know, asking him to pay, and he's not going to have. The Achil Kakule, but if he's going to start eating a lot of vegetables, Akikle demata shachiv. So then he's going to actually sleep in the Ashpot Ha'ir in an open place because he's going to, you know, be able to buy, right? Mizrotav zolim mizmumanim. So he's going to be able to sleep anywhere, right? In the Ashpot, in like the open places in the city because he's not going to have any problem. Meaning, if he's going to be buying expensive things, he's going to be having to hide out in his attic. But if he's going to be buying very cheap things, he could be anywhere and don't worry about it because since he's got the money, because he's buying cheap food, right? Vegetables, all these things to maintain him. So therefore, don't worry. Okay, Bezat Hashem, we continue tomorrow. Chodesh Tov to everybody.
Chazak Baruch.